a 1-for-1 trading system for Bedrock. Easy enough, 1 gold for 1 firework. Hey there guys, Skippy here for Roop, Skippy 6 Gaming, coming to you from Tutorial Land. Guys, Bedrock Tutorial Land is very difficult, and I'm pretty sure I left my world open because somebody did this, I think. I don't think that I did it, but at least it didn't ruin anything. Notice how they kept a safe distance. Guys, today we are going to do a simple, easy peasy 1-for-1 trading system in Bedrock. So I'm going to give a shout out to actually Mr. Crayfish. I know he doesn't usually do it, but I was looking through videos and I seen that he did one of these a long time ago. It does seem to work still, and it is very simple. So as you can see, we want to give 1 gold to get 1 firework, something that people most definitely will use. And yeah, so just go ahead and take your gold and get rid of your gold. The gold goes in, you hear a ding, and you got a firework. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Yeah, so for this one here, let's give the shout out to the newest members of Squad 6. We got David, Adam, Phoenix, and... oh my gosh, the last name, game, and yeah, so don't forget to jump into my Festive 50 giveaway. All the details is in this description below for the gleam.io app, and yeah, win yourself a 50 for the holiday season. So let's start this off, guys. I've already made the hole. As you can see, we've been playing with TNT. This is some sort of Elytra launcher, holy cow. For this build, let's tell you what you need. You're gonna need 3 redstone dust, 2 redstone torches, 2 comparators, 4 hoppers, 1 dropper, 1 lamp, 2 chests, 1 note block, and yeah, just bring 22 blocks-ish, and you should be good. You don't really need the note block, but I think it really makes a nice little addition. It does sound pretty clear. And yeah, so start off with your 5 long hole. This hole is going to be 3 deep, and it's going to be 2 wide. Perfect, perfect. And yeah, so let's grab our chest and start off in this corner here with a chest right here. Then we're going to want to put 2 hoppers, 1, 2, make sure you crouch place with your right trigger in to get that done. Once we've done this, let's grab a block of choice. Block of choice is going to go here, 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 and here. Look at that, we got a bunch of stuff going on now. Let's go ahead and take your comparator. Comparator goes out into this block. Then what we want to do is make sure that there's redstone dust here and here. Redstone torch right here. Then we're gonna go ahead and swing around here again. Like I said, this is easy, guys. Easy 1-for-1 trading system. Stare this guy up just like that. Once you've done this, go ahead and throw a redstone torch right here with a block on top. Now let's go over here, and what we're gonna do is do a quick little placement. We're going to put block right here, grab a dropper, dropper facing up. Hear the click, now you're cooking with gas. Let's go ahead over here and let's just back this guy up and put a block right here. Then what we're going to do is put another block right here. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Yeah, that's what they say. So now that we've done this, we're going to want to grab our redstone lamp, which is in our inventory right here. Grab your redstone lamp right here, redstone comparator right there. Now let's just swing around here and get the show on the road. So what we are going to do is grab your chest. This chest is going to go, as you can see right here, this chest goes right on top of that lamp. Chest right here, grab yourself 2 hoppers, crouch place, right trigger in, right here, right here. And then if you want to throw a note block on there, this is that moment in time. Let's grab a note block, and I guess we don't need any more chests, and this note block goes right there. So now we just got to basically set up this guy. I'm pretty sure it's this guy right here. Yep. And we're gonna have to make some dummy blocks. So let's see if I have an anvil around here. Did I blow it up with my shenanigans? I totally did. So the way that we're gonna make a new block is, let's grab an anvil. Yeah, throw it on the ground, throw it on the ground. And there. So way you do it is basically grab an anvil, throw your anvil down, grab 4 blocks that you don't need. So we'll use those dirt ones and rename them. So 4 blocks renamed. So now let's just rename them something that doesn't have a real name. And Juik. There you go. Juik is the word of the day. Skippy. Let's rename it Juik. Enter. Enter. And in addition to this, you know what we're going to do? We're just going to give raw chicken. Actually, you know what? We have to find something cool. So let's give, let's trade emeralds for diamonds. That's pretty straightforward, right? So, you know what we're going to do? Let's take this whole stack. Emeralds for diamonds. That's kind of a weird trade, but I think someone will take it. So let's go over with our rename blocks and let's go over here. Now let's head back over here and bottom hopper. First things first, grab this guy. Let's separate it. 18 of these, whatever it is that you want to get. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So go ahead and send that 18 into that bottom hopper. Oh my gosh, really? Just put 18 in. 1, 2, 3. And then once we've done this, go ahead and grab your rename blocks. You'll notice them because we have four and they're Juik. Put 1, 2, 3, 4. And there you go. So now we should be pretty much done. I think the only thing left to do is put what we want to purchase or get in here. So we're going to do diamonds, remember? I think that's what we decided was emeralds for diamonds. Let's go ahead and grab some diamonds. You could fill up this whole dude with it right here. Bang, and that shows that there is available items for you. Let's go ahead and shut this guy off. We want to do emeralds for diamonds. How easy, how hard is that? Well, we will find out right now. So we want to give emeralds. Did I just throw a whole stack of emeralds, really? So let's go ahead and throw. Did it just siphon all those emeralds in? And there we go. So that's the thing right there. As you notice, it worked, but I did make a small error. There's gonna be a diamond siphoning through here. So now let's try again. Because that block was in there blocking it, I'll show you exactly what to do to discourage that behavior again. You know what we're going to do right here to fix this is this right here. So let's try that one more time. And there we go. Perfect. So remember to fix up that little thing at the end there. I guess I'm a noob, but bring this guy up one more. The other thing is, guys, don't put a solid block here. So in that one here, I would grab a half slab or something like that. Looking good. Where's the half slabs? Yeah, that solid block messes it up, and we don't like that. So for this one here is always going to be a half slab. Don't let it have a block that will power. And then if you really wanted to, you could just build up the rest of your unit with half slabs. Looking good, feeling good, and awesome. Don't forget to smash that like. Actually, you could even put half slabs right here. I'm pretty sure a half slab will open. No, it won't, eh? This new fancy technology they have, I wonder if this will let it open. This bedrock's getting harder and harder to understand, but there you go, guys. Trading system for the win. Don't forget to smash that like before you go. Don't forget as well to subscribe to my channel for some cool stuff and stuff and stuff. I'm working on this thing. It just doesn't work properly. There's so many tutorials I'm making for Bedrock here, guys, where I start working on a tutorial and they do an update and it just doesn't work. They literally break everything almost immediately. But hey, what can you do? Don't forget to smash the like before you go and subscribe for some more daily Minecraft uploads. Thanks a lot for tuning in, guys, and I'll catch you on the next one.